If you're a science-minded individual and the 2016 electoral cycle has you thinking like Professor Hubert J. Farnsworth saying, I don't want to live on this planet anymore, then good news, you might be able to not, in spirit at least for now, because scientists are proposing a new nation state in space and is allowing Earthlings, to apply for citizenship.
Is that your word,
Earthlikans? Yeah.
That's a good
I made
word.
It up. That is not the official word.
That's a good word.
To describe this, this is a little bit of a novel concept. They say, according to independent.co.uk, the new space station of Asgardia hopes to save the human race twice over. First, it will look to protect it from warfare in space, and second, it will try and keep humanity safe from the dangers coming from outside of atmosphere, protecting us from threats like space debris and asteroid collisions. The country will send its first satellite into space in 2017. From there, Asgardia hopes to open up access to space for commerce, science, and peoples of all countries on Earth. It is being led by Uygur Asher Bailey, who leads the Aerospace International Research Center in Vienna and is chairman of UNESCO's Science and Space Committee. But Asgardia was created in consultation with globally renowned scientists, engineers, entrepreneurs, and legal experts, according to those behind it. Asgardia is a fully fledged and independent nation, well, prospectively, and a future member of the United Nations. With all the attributes this status entails, Asgardia is also unique from a philosophical aspect to serve entire humanity and each and every one, regardless of his or her personal welfare and the prosperity of the country where they happen to be born.
I like that Uygur is building this.
Thinking of like, whereas our previous story was about Judge John McBain and his badass name. I don't think they knocked it out of the park with Asgardia.
Oh yeah. Now let's talk about the goofy
stuff. That's based on Norse legend, you know, of Thor and
I'm sure
Odin.
There's more than one Norse legend.
Asgard.
A different one.
No, when I saw Thor the movie, I was like, really? Asgardia?
Yes. Right?
And so when I saw it, I know what it refers to, and I love, like, why not use Valhalla? Valhalla is an awesome word.
That's heaven.
Yeah, you're going up to the heavens,
no,
Valhalla.
No, that implies the battle is over. You're still pushing for it.
Okay. South Valhalla.
You know, East Valhalla State.
Totally. Yeah.
Right, but Asgardia. Okay, I know we're goofballs. I'm continuing along that line for one more second. You know, you left out one thing that was going to protect us from Kim. They actually mentioned it twice in the article. Coronal mass ejections.
Yeah, that's a thing.
Yeah, no, I know it is. It's from the sun, okay, but it sounds funny. Okay, we've got to build Asgardia to protect us from the mass ejections.
Yeah, that's a thing. I'm too mature for this.
Okay, now, having said all that, I'm a little skeptical that they're actually going to build and people are going to be up there.
Oh, you're a little skeptical?
No, but actually, only a little, because things are advancing really, really quickly. If you said 10 years ago this story, I'd be like, yeah, okay, Uygur, save it, right? But these days, Asher Bailey, he's actually Turkic, so God help us all. But anyway, but these days, I don't know, they're building amazing things, and SpaceX is going up there a lot, and then we got a lot of smart scientists in the world, and Elon Musk keeps saying, no, you don't understand, we have to get off the planet. And he's one of the smartest guys in the world, so I'm starting to get a little worried. So all kidding aside, I'm like, hey, Dr. Asher Bailey, keep going.
Well,
what do you think? You're the nerd alert chief.
I mean, this
chief.
Week we've been talking about, like, in particular, President Obama wrote an opinion piece for CNN that was outlaying plans and ideas for having NASA and private companies work together to send humans to Mars and have them return, which is different from the SpaceX ideal, which is you stay there and you live there and you die there. And this is something we do need to push for. I know it seems crazy and too idealistic at this point, but the idea of, I guess, kind of a Star Trek world where we're united and we're focused on higher pursuits besides all the stupid differences that we have is such a good thing to reach for. And yeah, I know it's not the most realistic thing in the world, but it does represent an ideal that I think a lot of people would strive for. He said to space.com, if you look at a nation's population statistically, 2% are creative and productive and progressive, so we hope, looking at the population of Earth, 7.5 billion, we hope 150 million would be those people who would feel this way and apply for citizenship, which is something that they would need to do to be recognized by the UN.
So I look, I love the idea behind it, and I'm a huge Star Trek fan. In fact, you got me the sweatshirt that I wear. I wore it this morning.
The
Captain Kirk one, yes. And
I have the science officer one. I'm just saying.
That's right. So
I have the generic red-shirted guy gets killed 17 minutes into the episode.
Cool.
So if I were gonna trust any
Henderson.
Totally. Yeah. If I were gonna trust any profession to build a model society, it would probably be scientists, right? Because and maybe engineers, because what I love about engineers is that you've got to use logic, you've got to complete the task, you can't half build a bridge, you can't even 98% build a bridge, otherwise it's going to collapse, mm-hmm. right? So you got to think it through, you got to be logical, you can't, deal in fantasy and mythology, and the same is true of scientists. So you got to get it right, and there's, are they more likely to set up laws based on reason, logic, and look out for one another? I hope so. I believe so. So I love the idea behind this. The problem is when they get invaded by the libertarian colony, right? The libertarians
are they starting their own group to oppose them, or are they within this group spreading as like a seed?
No. Luckily, the libertarians haven't thought this far ahead. They're just building a colony in the water. They're thinking of building an island in the ocean. But eventually, the libertarians are fairly rich, right? They'll get up in space, and then we'll have Star Wars. We'll go from Star Trek to Star Wars.
Well, I don't want to live in Star Wars as much as I love it.
I don't know. I would go. I would love to be the first black man to be the citizen of wherever we're going.
Then
I'd
be
in
Agardia.
Look, some of those 2% creative people are coming up with a better name.
Like, okay, fine. Like, I mean, what it represents is more important to me than you being not liking the word Asgard.
By the way, how is this graphic not Ask Guardians of the Galaxy?
Yeah. I thought they would go with Thor.
It's a huge miss. Yeah.
Another Marvel movie, sure.
So, but we're all, except for Ben, who's obsessed with the names, we're agreed that it sounds like a lovely idea.
It's a lovely idea. I think it's a one-day thing because, I mean, there will be a time when we're not a monoplanetary species, hopefully. And we need to think ahead. We have people today training to be space lawyers because this is kind of an uncharted territory. Like, I don't mean, literally and figuratively, which is we don't have these rules and governances in space yet. So this is something we need to think about and something that probably will happen, and that's a good thing.
At the Young Turks, we're in the business of changing the media. Come change it with us. TYTnetwork.com/join. That one was powerful. That was a good, serious one, okay?